Hello everyone and welcome to this week's Adobe scripting tutorial. In this one, I'm going to be showing you how to make a basic Illustrator script, which when we run it, will generate a bunch of things for us, including a background layer, a triangle shape where we can define our own path, as well as some text. This is just sort of acting like a template where you could put in your own sort of name here and do whatever you want. This is going to be more of a beginner's tutorial for those of you who are not familiar with Illustrator very much or scripting or programming. It's going to be about 50 lines of code, but most of it will be easy to explain and use English words that match everything inside of Illustrator. And over time, I'll release more Illustrator videos to illustrate more deeper concepts and get a little bit more advanced. Before we get started, I just want to remind you down below, make sure to hit the subscribe button and hit the bell icon to be notified of when videos come out twice weekly on the channel. And down in the description of this video, you can check out the code in the GitHub link, and you can also follow us on Instagram there to get updates as well. If you want to join the Discord server as well, you can come and join and get help or help others with scripting, extensions, plugins, and expressions. So let's go ahead and get started. What are we going to need to make a script for Adobe Illustrator, and what is a script? Well, a script is essentially going to allow us to automate a process or automate a whole bunch of processes and go into different areas of Illustrator, whether it be the layers where we have different abilities to layer things, or we can go in and adjust the fill colors or paths or things like that. In our case, we're just going to be making a script where we can go in and change the name of our company. Let's say we just did MT Productions. And then it's going to take our input and use this templated sort of design we've made with the script and generate all of the same elements each time. In the description, there will be two links to the resources we're going to be using and sometimes taking a look at as we go along in our journey learning Adobe Illustrator. So the first document you want to take a look at is the Adobe Illustrator CC scripting guide, and this actually has multiple ways of scripting inside of it. You can use AppleScript, JavaScript, VBScript, and we want to use JavaScript. So on page 40 is sort of where the code for what we're going to be doing begins. And it just has some basic examples like creating a hello world and how to access different levels of Illustrator hierarchy, as well as how to change the properties and positions of things. So the first resource is more of a self-help guide to help get started and learn how it works. The second is going to be the Illustrator scripting guide as a whole, which has all the objects and properties we need to learn about what things we can manipulate, add, and change inside of our script. So inside of here, you have things like entire brush section where you can access the brushes of Illustrator. And there's so many different things in Illustrator you can go through and see. And each one of them has an ability to check out the properties. Like if I want to change the font of something, I can check out the text font and all of the properties like the name, the parent, and the styling of it. And then finally, to what you're going to use to code your script, you can use any coding program you want. We're basically going to be writing things in JavaScript. We're going to be using ExtendScript, which in some OSs is not supported anymore. But you can also use Visual Studio Code, Xcode, Notepad, whatever you feel. So the first thing we're going to do is open a new JavaScript file and begin writing our script. The first thing I want to do is check if there's an open project that we can close, because we're going to be creating a new document. And every time we create a new document, we don't want it just to have 100 open. So we want to close the previous one if there's one already open. The way we're going to do that is starting with an if statement. We're going to check if something is true or false. And in our case, we're going to check if our application or Adobe Illustrator, and we're going to check if home screen visible. And what this will do is if the home screen, which appears like this, where it says home, if this is visible, it's going to give you a true value. So if the home screen is visible in Adobe Illustrator, we know that we can just create a new document. We don't have to close the previous one. So we actually want to say the opposite if it's not visible. The way we can do that is invert the logic with an exclamation mark. So if the home screen is not visible, that's actually safe to say that something is already opened up. And if something's already opened up in Illustrator, we want to close it. The way we're going to do that is say app, and then we're going to say active document, which is basically just saying what is the document that's open. And in this case, we have one open right here. So we're going to then grab it and say close. And if we want to close it without having anything say, do you want to save your changes? We can just give it this argument called save options, do not save changes. And if you want to find more of these, you can just go into the scripting guide. And once you find save options, you can see we have save options, do not save changes, or we can force it to save changes or prompt to save the changes. So you can check out more information inside the scripting guide when you can't find exactly what the argument or requirement is. So now if we test this out, I'm going to link it up with Adobe Illustrator. If you aren't using ExtendScript, you can just run the script inside of it. And I'll hit run, and you can see it then closes the project, which is exactly what we want. Now we have a fresh slate, let's create a new one and start beginning to make our shapes. First thing we're gonna do is create a new document called My Document, and this is just gonna be a new sort of canvas we're opening up. So we're gonna say application.documents, we're referring to all the documents in our app, Adobe Illustrator, and we're gonna say .add. So this is going to store a new document into our variable, but also create it visually in the program. So if I go ahead and run this, it should just open up a blank document just like that. Now I'm gonna create a function called generate background. I'm gonna make a basically background, just a plain color background. And I'm gonna then define my function, generate background. One thing to note is we've now created our document and opened it up. It's now going to be also referenced as our active document. So what we can do inside of generate background is get our document and say app.activeDocument. Then we're going to create our background itself and apply it to whatever our first layered by default here is. So we basically want to create sort of a giant box fill with whatever color we choose. So I'll say background is equal to our document.pathItems. We want to reference all the path items. And just like before, we'll say .add. Then to make sure our background has a fill, we can say background.filled is equal to true. If you wanted to make sure it had a stroke, you could say .stroked is equal to true. Now, if you're familiar with colors and programming, typically you're going to use HSB or HSV or something like RGB or even hex values, but in Illustrator we use CMYK. So we're going to create a new object called our background fill color, and we're going to create a new CMYK color, which is just cyan, magenta, yellow, and black. You can check out a CMYK color picker to get whatever color you want, and then input the data based on these values. So all we have to do is say, for example, our background fill color dot cyan will set to be 4, and then we go through and fill in the other values. So I'll make magenta 2, yellow 97, and black just 1. And then to set the actual fill color, we first made sure our background was filled, but now to set the color it's filled with, we're gonna say background.fillColor is equal to our object we just made called backgroundFillColor. We're gonna use those CMYK values to fill in our background. So now if I go ahead and run the script, you can see our background fill color is undefined because I used a U instead of an O. So if I go ahead and run it now, you can see it hasn't quite made anything yet. And I believe that's because we need to now set the path of our background. So I'm gonna grab background and say dot sets entire path. And what we're gonna do is just provide it with an array of all the points that we want to fill it with. And since we're making a square, we have 4 points, 1, 2, 3, 4. We're gonna just define those points now. The first point is going to be 0, 0 up in the left corner here. The second point is right here, which is the width of our document, and then 0 for y. So I'll say doc.width and 0. Then down here is going to be our width and height. So I'll say doc.width and doc.height. And then lastly, we have our height here is our height of our document, and our width is 0. Now let's go ahead and run this. And we actually need to enclose this entire thing in its own brackets. Try it again. Now you can see we're gonna get our CMY color applied as our background to the proper dimensions of our entire composition. And if you look inside of your layers, you now have that information inside of here as well. Now after we've made our background, let's do a script that will create a new layer. And in this layer, we're going to apply the triangle you saw by then defining the vertices, very similar to what we just did here, where we set the entire path. So after we generate our background, we're going to create a variable called layer2, and we're going to say myDocument.layers. We're going to refer to all these layers, and we're going to say .add. Then I'll change the name of layer2. So I'll say layer2.name is equal to our triangle layer, And also, we haven't really created our first layer because it comes already with our document. But when we create our document, we can say my document.layers1.name is equal to our background layer. That will grab our first layers. And actually, this needs to be an array in the first value because the layers gives you a full array of all of the layers. So we're going to first set the first layer name to background layer, and the second layer, which we're about to create, is the triangle layer. So now you can see we have two layers, our background layer and our triangle layer. Now we can populate our triangle layer. So I'll say generate triangle as a function, and then we'll define it down here. And our triangle is going to be very similar to our background, but way more simple. So I'm going to first define our doc again as our app.activeItem, or sorry, our active document. And then we're going to say var triangle is equal to our doc.pathItems, and we're going to add one. And then instead of filling our triangle, we're going to stroke it. So I'm going to say triangle.stroked is equal to true. And then now we can define our set entire path similar to how we did up here. So I'm going to say triangle.setEntirePath. And now again, we can provide it with what we'll need is, I believe, 3 or 4 vertices to create this triangle. I'm going to go ahead and copy and paste them from the previous project because it is a little bit long, but we need 4 of these paths. And it's going to basically be right here, 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 and then we have to go back to the original point to close out our stroke. So the first path is basically our width divided by 2, so halfway here, and then 25 pixels down. That's going to be the very tippy top point of our triangle. The second point is going to be 25 pixels over here, and then our height minus 25. So it's going to go there to there. And the next point is our width minus 25, and then our height minus 25, which will put the point there. And then the last point will go back to the original point. So we'll start here, go here, then there, and then back to the original. So now if we run this, you can see my explanation was a little bit off. It's actually flipped 180 degrees, which is fine. We're getting the triangle we want just based on setting our path. The last thing we're going to do is create a layer for our text. So we're going to say layer 3 is equal to my document.layers. And we're going to add another layer. We're going to call the layer name. We'll just make it our text layer. And then we'll go ahead and say generate text. We're going to define a function called generate text. And actually, whatever string we give it is going to be the text. So I'll say NT Productions. And then down here, we need to define this function called generate text with the argument of whatever text we're going to change it to. So now we're going to go ahead and define our doc again, our app.activeDocuments. And now we're going to define our text. We'll just call it like our text layer kind of. And we're going to set this equal to our doc.textFrames.add. So we're going to be referencing the built-in text frames of Illustrator. Instead of creating some paths, we're going to create a text object, which is sort of its own individual thing. Then I'll grab my text layer and set the name to be whatever our text is. And this is just going to set the name in our panel right here to be whatever the name is. To set the actual value of the text to be typed out whatever we want, we need to grab the contents of our text. So I'll say textLayer.contents is equal to text. So if you want to change the text itself, just grab the contents and set it to a string. So now I'm going to create a variable called textRange. And the textRange is a property for whenever you create a piece of text inside of Illustrator, it's going to contain all of the information like the size, the font, the justification. So I'll say textLayer.textRange. And then we can use this text range to grab things like the size and set this to maybe like 36 pixels. And I can also say maybe grab the justification. So I'll say textRange.justification and we'll set it to a center type justification. So now if we go ahead and run this and see how it looks, you can see we've created our text that says NT Productions, but it's all the way down in the bottom. So what we can do is move the position by saying textLayer.position. And we need to set it to an X and a Y position. I have an algorithm which I'll just paste in to position it where I want and test it out here. So you can see now it's not quite in the center, but it's a little bit off on the padding. But you can use the dot position property as well to change the position. So after that, you can go in and start messing around with the values and exploring what the different properties of these built-in objects are. For those of you who have stayed around, I'm going to show you one more bonus thing, how to export an image. So we're going to call our my documents. and we're gonna say export file. Now export file takes two arguments. The first is the file that you want to export. In my case, I'm going to just create a file called test.png inside of my documents folder. And then the other part is basically the type you want to export. If you go into the guide and search for export type, we can see all of the different types of things we can export. And in my case, I want to export a PNG. So I'll copy this and we'll paste it in as the second argument. And now if I go ahead and run it, didn't tell us we exported a file, but if I go to my documents, here is my test.png image. And that's gonna do it for this simple beginner's Adobe Illustrator script tutorial. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, hit the thumbs up button. Down below, hit subscribe and hit the bell icon to be notified of new videos coming out twice weekly on the channel. If you have any questions or comments, of course, leave them down in the comment section. If you wanna check out the code to try this out for yourself and start expanding and learning a little bit more piece by piece of Adobe Illustrator scripting, check out the GitHub link in the description. And down there, you can also follow us on Instagram. If you want to reach out to the scripting, extensions, plugins, and expressions community we've started building, you can join the Discord server and get questions answered and help others. But that's going to do it for this week's video, guys. I hope you enjoyed a new scripting topic that's now beginning on the channel. We'll see you next time.